Now we're gonna look at a basic side control bottom escape, the hand speed.
Alright, I've messed up. Barney's passed my guard. He's got me flat on my back. This is the worst possible place. This escape is taught first in the series because it relies on the fundamentals that we teach white belts. Good hip movement through shrimping, getting your back off the floor, and then turning into drive. Those are the three things that we really want to focus on. This escape only works when they have the hand over control. As you get better, you'll be able to do this when they really control with their hands. But the important thing right here is that I make my hand spear and I put it in the armpit. It doesn't matter if he's staying so tight that I can't get it in, you just put it at the door. This is a safe place for this hand. There's no kimuras, there's no key locks, and if he makes any space to try and take control of this hand, I'm going to use it as an opportunity to stuff it into the pommel or underhook so that I can move out the back. So I've got this hand spear in. I'm going to start to move my hips. One, look, my back is starting to come off the floor. Two, my back is off the floor. Three. Now that I'm in here, this hand spear is going to come all the way through. I'm going to dip my head. I'm going to come out here. I'm going to hug the leg. It's important that when we come in to hug that leg, that the hand that comes around the back goes flat on the floor as well as the elbow. The hand that's on the floor, the other hand comes over on top. Now, a lot of people when they do this, especially beginners, won't put that elbow on the floor. That's going to lead into problems with people omoplotting you, and not you won't be able to put good pressure on that hip. The pressure we're going to bind on the hip is not a lifting of the leg. My white belts do that, man. It irritates me so bad. They get in here and they lift up. My wrestlers do that. Stop it. Stop it right now. All right? We come in here, hand on the floor, elbow on the floor. My setup hand comes in. My bottom is high and I'm driving into the leg. I'm driving it into the floor. I'm not picking it up. Once I'm here, I'm going to rotate and I'm going to rotate. Notice how Marty's hip locks out and you see him come out and then he'll choose to either take the bottom or he'll collapse all the way down onto his stomach. Either way, I'm gonna climb up the back. But it's important you keep that elbow on the floor. Let's look at it again. I'm inside, man. Hand spear, I put it at the door. I'm gonna start moving my hips away. One, two, three. I get my head inside, I hug that leg. Elbow's on the floor. I'm putting good pressure in. I walk, and I drive him down. It looks like he's just playing along, guys, like he's just sitting down. I promise you get that good pressure and you lock out that hip, it's gonna look just like that, but it's not easy for him. I promise he's not giving me anything. Really, just try to rep it out. Let's look at one more thing that I think is gonna be important that some of us miss. I've come in here, I get my hand spear. A lot of us are gonna start moving out and our head right here is gonna get stuck. Oh man, this is terrible. I can't turn in if this is here. It's okay to put your hand on the hip right here and make a little bit of space this way. If you can't get your head to the inside, you can't do this, guys. You'll have to start bringing the knee in and doing something else. We'll go over that later. But here, I want to get my head to the inside so that I can belly down. I get a hold of that leg. I rotate, and I take him over. Look at it again from another angle. I'm here, I put my hand spear in. I move. I duck my head. Watch this arm, guys. It comes up, around, and I catch. Look at how deep it went. I'm driving in. My other hand goes on top. Now I'm going to drive.